Hi and welcome to Newsclick. I'm Glenisa and here we give you a glimpse of some of the most important stories that made headlines today. The National Council of Education, Research and Training, or NCERT, has dropped three chapters from its Class 9 history textbook, including one that illustrates caste conflict. This chapter was about the struggle of the lower caste Nadar women of Travancore who were forced to keep their upper bodies uncovered. This chapter also focused on the importance of the Swadeshi movement, explained how it influenced the politics of clothing, and also talked about Mahatma Gandhi's experiments with clothing to show the changing attitude towards dressing in India. The decision to delete almost 70 pages from the textbook, titled India and the Contemporary World I, is part of the curriculum rationalization exercise initiated at HRD Minister Prakash Javidekar's behest to reduce the burden on the students. This is the second textbook review undertaken under the incumbent government. The revised textbook will hit the shelves this month before the new academic session begins. This is not the first time that the right-wing BJP government is trying to alter history. In 2017, NCERT has made 1,334 changes, which included additions, corrections, and data updating in 182 textbooks. The students of Rajiv Gandhi National University of Law, Patiala, continued their protest on Sunday as well against the suspension of six students. The protest has been going on from last Friday after six students were suspended for demonstrating against the quality of food in the hostel mess. A committee constituted of the administrative officer and other faculty took the decision to suspend the students. However, the suspension order was passed without a formal hearing and in the absence of VC students alleged. The students of National Law University have been complaining against unreasonable library timings, restrictions on the mobility of women and their end timings, incompetent faculty and indifference to sexual harassment complaints for a long time. But the college administration has not acknowledged any one of the complaints. Students of the National Law School of India University, Bengaluru, have reportedly offered their support to the protesters. And in our international segment, we are talking about Venezuela crisis. In a recent development over this weekend, a huge mobilization took place in front of the US embassies in the major parts of the world. The people in the march called out the US for its military intervention and for provoking destabilization in the southern American countries. The call for the mobilization came from the International People's Assembly in solidarity with the Bolivarian Revolution and against imperialism, which took place in Caracas, Venezuela, in the month of February. Across the world, the eight-starred Venezuelan flag flew high with overwhelming support for the Venezuelan government and its people. The 500 delegates from 85 countries representing over 180 organizations left the assembly with a commitment to intensify the campaign of solidarity with Venezuela in their own countries. So that's all we have for you today. For more updates, please log in to our website www.newsclick.in and follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube.